Let us discuss the point principle of flexible approach of learning in module number 1. Based on nature of learning differences and the design of supporting learning environment, the flexible approach of learning principle map into three brain network. They are recognition, strategic and affective network that plays a primary role in learning. There are three flexible approach of learning principles are as follows. First one is to support recognition learning. It means to provide multiple means of representation, that is, offer flexible ways to present what we teach and learn. Second one, to support strategic learning. It means to provide multiple means of action and expression, that is, flexible options for how we learn and express what we know. Third one is to support affective learning. It means to provide multiple means of engagement, that is, flexible options for generating and sustaining motivation, the why of learning. When you observe these three principles, the three things are important. What we teach and learn. Second one is express what we know. And third one is why of learning. The three key terms involved in flexible approach of learning, that is representation, action and expression, and student engagement. These three things are very important in flexible approach of learning. So in representation, flexible approach of learning recommends offering information in more than one format. Generally, in traditional teaching, we only present verbal explanation or only one media we have to follow, only one format. We are not using different format as per the learner's time. But in flexible approach of learning, while representing some concepts, some explanation, some key terms, you have to present with multiple format. Second one is the action and expression. Flexible approach of learning suggests giving kids more than one way to interact with the material and to show what they have learned. Action and expression means student can give response to you in various format, either verbally, either facial expression, or some doing some activity purpose, or some examples, or they can express in variety of ways what they have learned. And third one is the student engagement. Flexible approach of learning encourages teachers to look for multiple ways to motivate students. If you want to engage your student in your teaching process, so you have to give them some motivations, variety of experience time to time. So you should alert their learning styles. So here in this slide, many types of instructional methods are given, which are all learner-centric method. You can adopt in your flexible learning approach. Here, first one is the cooperative. In the cooperative learning involved, you can create your group as per your choice. Give them some freedom to work in any other group. So student can involve in small group working together to accomplish a learning task. It is a cooperative way of learning. Presentation. Presentations are learners presented assignments. Student can do these in group or individual. You can give them freedom to present their assignments either individually or in group format, or as per their other way, in the written format or in verbal format. Panel and experts. Panels are a way to include many voices on a subject. Student can write and ask the questions in a question answer session. Or you can arrange question answer session separately and give them opportunity to express themselves, whatever they learn, to ask freely and give them opportunity in the panel discussion or experts meet. KWL, K means knowledge, WL, put it on the poster. What do you know means K, want to know, learn, how about the enhanced version, KWHLO chart. You have to create KWL chart, what they know, what they want to know, and what they learn. You have to prepare such type of chart in your classroom so students come and write as per their learning. Then you can arrange brainstorming session in your classroom. Brainstorming puts the thinkers to work, present a situation, ask learners to creatively think. You have to present some situations, student work collaboratively or cooperative learning, and they can work creatively. You can use media also. You have to use some PPT presentation, you have to show them some video, some audio material. You can take discussion in the classroom, present an issue and have the student talk about it. If they need, add some information and find out some more solution. In the small group discussion, student can work very efficiently. They can learn as per their own choice and they can interact easily and share their ideas freely with each other. Use case studies in the classroom to learn about complex issues. Apply critical thinking. Some complex issues you have to study, you want to know, so let them express in the group and you have to observe carefully to your students. Jigsaw puzzle method, you can give them brain challenge activity. Then learning center, break up the classroom into different activities. After a set time, ask student to rotate in other group. You have to create small center in your classroom so student can engage and sustain their interest and they can happily involve in your teaching learning process. Design small experiment as per their interest and as per their way of learning. So in this way, student can engage in flexible approach of learning. So my dear teacher, you have to introduce all types of teaching methods in your classroom and you have to apply, you have to implement all types of variety of teaching learning experience with different format, variety of representation with lots of action and expression, so student can engage themselves and sustain their interest throughout their teaching learning process. So it is a major benefit of flexible approach of learning. This is now in module 1 we have studied the principle of flexible approach of learning, objectives of flexible approach of learning, and some concepts of flexible approach of learning. So what is it really useful for teachers to adopt flexible approach of learning? The answer is yes, because we can give the equal justice to our learner. You can master to use variety of teaching learning process. You can give your student variety of opportunities to learn themselves. You can success to sustain student interest in your teaching and engage thoroughly in teaching learning process. And other benefits, you have to express yourself and write your key points here. What are the benefits of flexible approach of learning? And if you want to more information, please visit this blog, click on link and visit blog and take more information about what are the benefits of flexible approach of learning. So thank you so much.